Well, the show's called A Happening, and...
Yeah.
That's the commercial.
That's the song.
Okay. So, I don't know this version. And so I was going to sing this song, you know? Because this song's like, you know, me and learning like pop and Diana Ross and the Supremes are like pop sensation and, you know, like Detroit is like mainstream, you know? So I was going to sing that song. Anyway, if you don't have it, don't worry about it. I was going to have that song play while I do the poem that I always start my performance with. Easy on the eye. I'm not really very pretty. I'm just easy on the eye. I'm nothing much at which to look, and I've discovered why. Some look at me and wonder. Some look on me and scowl. Some try to look me under, but I'm wiser than the owl. Some try to overlook me. I'm too here now for that. I am tall and thin and beautiful. I am ugly, dark, and fat. My looks are purely powerful. You'll see what you need see. My guises are a tower. For my one disguise is me. I'm really quite transparent. To see me is to see something dull or iridescent. You'll see yourself in me. Here's something to reflect on. Will your description be something vile or veneration from looker to lookee? See here your harmony and health. See here your discontent. See here your hated other self. See here your compliment. See here one bright and shiny soul all too soon breaking free. See, here's a body growing old and in a rate. I really feel it today. And here's a head on me. An easy lesson simply thought, simply taught, but difficult to deny. What you see is what you brought. I'm easy on the eye. Until the end, and I'm gonna sing a song at the end, and I'm just gonna read, and you don't have to clap after everyone. This one is called The Calling. Everyone gets one, many have two, but who knew? I have more than a few. Jack of all trades, master of none, chosen one, soon I will be done. Man of many jobs, will work to eat, make ends meet, my works to complete. Answer the calling, follow the heart, stop, start, all to perform my part. The meaning of life, reason to live, got to give, got to be productive. Callings are golden, they are not gold. I'm growing old, trying not to grow cold. A door will open, I will go in. That's when I've got the call again. Everyone gets one, many have two, but who knew I have more than a few? Universalism, I had a secret. No one but me knew this secret. In the beginning, it was so much a secret, I kept it for myself. I know better now. I'm totally woke now. I have the awareness and I am completely committed to myself. I am being selfish and practicing radical self-love. This self-love is radical because it calls for total self-acceptance and extreme compassion for the one who is I. Here's what I have learned. The more I keep the focus on myself, the safer I become. The more I practice speaking from the I, the more certain I am of my safety. The more I identify and qualify myself, the more I feel connected to the universe. The more I'm honest, open, and willing to share my experience, strength, and hope, the more universal my message becomes. When I keep a microscope on the internal matters, my qualification magnifies universal realities. The definition of universalism, often capitalized, is a theological doctrine that all human beings will eventually be saved. It is a Christian belief that insists that Christ's atonement did atone for the sins of all mankind. My definition of universalism is a personal doctrine. I choose to believe that all human beings will eventually be safe. That world peace is possible. That there is a place for everyone at the table. This is a byproduct of my personal practice of Christianity and of my connection to my higher power. The more salvation I give to myself, the more I contribute to universal salvation. The more I love and take care of myself, the more truth, beauty, and serenity I bring into the universe. The state of being universal is my state of being universally me. I find solace in the words of Mac Ehrman, who wrote the poem Desiderata. I have interpreted this poem as my personal affirmation. I am a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. I have a right to be here. And whether or not it is clear to me, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Unattended, I was so pleased to be on top of it, so proud, so very proud not to be carried away with the whole messy thing that I announced my days. What was it after all, but just a nervous spill, not an altogether unheard of condition in this analyst conscious culture. Now I've returned to the scene of the crime. My foolish pride and my vanity caused me to feel I've fully recovered. It's been away for months. Where has all the time gone? I was right here all the time, but I was asleep. A more controlled facet of myself drove me through the mania. Things put down in April and May, resurfacing in June, going on July, and still not put away, not returned to normal in August. To whom have I made promises? Who have I disappointed? Put aside myself. Have I been spun around? Indeed, I have circumnavigated my soul. When did my hair and nails grow so long? Have I been inattentive to self? Have I not been attentive to me? How long have I been unattended? Cat, ass, trophies. I keep on winning one cat, ass, trophy after another. Fires, floods, hurricanes, and tornadoes, infestations, molestations, droughts, drafts, and displacement. I keep on winning. Hospital bills, overdraft statements, disappointments, service interruptions, government ills, mid-season replacements, potions, anointments, crisis and corruption. I keep on winning. I keep on, I keep on winning. I keep on, I keep on winning. I keep on winning cat-ass trophies. He was excited. He was more than excited. In the morning, he'd ride with Steve. He was more than excited this morning. He'd ride to Chicago with Steve. Where's my keys? Where's my cash? He knew he was flipping when he was on the porch giving Faye, on the porch with Faye, playing that game again. I'm going to Chicago and I'm going to take A, an apple, she'd say. I'm going to Chicago and I'm going to take A, an apple, B, a button. Button, button, who's got the button, he said. He thought, I'm going to Chicago and I'm going to take A, an apple, B, a button. No, C, cookies, said June. D, said Gregory. E, said man. F, said Freddie, Katie, Johnny. It was all he could do to fold his Kango into a crescent shape. I can't take you. I raised just a bit. I raised the window just a bit to let the air in and sprayed Lysol. It was all he could do to pack eats. He'd bring lunch, bring along food, he packed snacks. He had bread but no butter he could spread. He brought two cups of ice wrapped in paper and plastic. Cups of ice he brought two wrapped in paper and plastic too. They could melt nicely for tea. They could melt nicely for tea. He had herbs and spiced tea. I'm going to Chicago. He took A, an article from the newspaper to read. B, the book he took, the book Maurice, for when he went out. And to share, he took care, and cookies, fig Newtons, strawberry Newtons, apple Newtons, D. He took when he went on, when he went out, when he went in. He tried another pen. Everything. He saved everything. The light began to hum. Now he knew 15 minutes had passed since he'd come home. That's how long it had been since he clicked the switch. The light began to hum. Oh, shut up, he said to the annoying humming. Oh, shut up, he said to the full spectrum fluorescent black light, infrared, ultraviolet, halogen light bulb. He went out. He went in. Where's his pen? He went, he wrote, and he wrote till his pen had no ink, till his pen ran out of ink. So in pencil he wrote of the house, of his dreams. He scented of Florida water and mountain juniper. He scented of Florida, of mountain water, of he scented of mountain juniper and Florida citrus water. His holy water ritual of days once seen. He washed his face first with water and genteel. And gentle, delicate, with antiseptic, sensitive, Dove, blue marble, whatever soap. He then rinsed it off with more water, water more than shaving cream, mentholated a lather for the shave with, then an alcohol rub down, moisturizer. In summer and winter, when he didn't shower, he'd wash himself up, he'd wash himself down, a French bath, a horse bath, a bird bath, he recalled, black hair color, a once a week routine. Strange messages left on the machine. I can't. I just can't. I can't do it anymore, Steve, but call me tomorrow. He was more than excited. He was more than excited in the morning he'd ride with Steve. He was more than excited this morning he'd ride to Chicago with Steve. Where's my keys? Where's my cash? He knew he was slipping when he was on the porch with Faye playing that game again. I'm going to Chicago and I'm going to take A, an apple, she'd say. I'm going to Chicago and I'm going to take A, an apple, B, button. Button, button, who's got the button, he'd say. He thought, I'm going to Chicago and I'm going to take A, an apple, B, a button. C, cookies, said June. D, said Gregory. E, said man. F, said Freddie, Katie, Johnny. It was all he could do to pack a wardrobe. He folded his Kangol into a crescent shape to pack. Then he sang, going to Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you. Going to Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you. Going to Chicago. Sorry, but I can't take you. He raised the window just a bit to let the air in and sprayed Lysol off. It was all he could do to pack eats. He'd bring lunch, bring along food. He'd pack snacks. He'd bring bread, but no butter he could spread. He brought two cups of ice wrapped in paper and plastic. Cups of ice he brought two wrapped in paper and plastic. Two, he could melt. They would melt nice for tea. They would melt nicely for tea. He made herb and spice tea. I'm going to Chicago. He took an article from the newspaper to read. B, a book he took, the book Maurice, for when he went out and to share. C, and to care. He took care. And cookies. Fig Newtons. Strawberry Newtons, apple Newtons, he took. When he went out, when he went in, he tried another pen. Everything, he saved everything. The light began to hum. Now he knew 15 minutes had passed since he'd come, and that's how long it had been since he clicked the switch. The light began to hum. Oh, shut up, he said, to the annoying humming. Oh, shut up, he said. Told the full spectrum, fluorescent, black light, infrared, ultraviolet, halogen, light bulb. He went out, he went in. Where's his pen? He wrote, and he wrote, till his pen had no ink, till his pen ran out of ink. So in pencil he wrote of the house of his dreams. He scented of Florida water and mountain juniper. He scented of mountain juniper and Florida citrus water, his holy water ritual of days once seen. He washed his face first with water and gentle, delicate, and antiseptic, sensitive Dove, blue marble, whatever soap, then rinsed it off with more water, water more, then shaving cream, mentholated, and lathered face, the shave, the blue Gillette, then the alcohol rub down moisturizer. In summer and winter, when he didn't shower, he washed himself up, he washed himself down, a French bath, a horse bath, a bird bath, he recalled, black hair color, once a week, routine. Strange message left on the machine. I can't, I can't, I can't do it anymore, Stephen. They call me tomorrow. You now, can you put the music on for me?
Yes.
You know, I love to sing. I sang all my life through, like, you know, little kids sing, and then I sang through college. I love to sing, and I love to sing with a group of people. When I first moved to New York, I used to like look for a job, and I could never find a job, and I would sit home and I'd play this record over and over and over again. Anyway, this is the song that I learned when I first moved to New York, and it's actually appropriate for right now at this very moment. Played his games on me so long. I started to believe I'd never find anyone
doubt and try to convince me to give in. Said you can't win. Then one day the sun came shining through. The rain had stopped and the skies were blue. And oh, what a revelation to see. Someone was saying, I love you to me. A one in a million.
Yeah. I don't know if I can do that.
Life had played this game on me so long. I started to believe I'd never find anyone. Doubt tried to convince me to give in. Said you can't win. Then one day the sun it came a shining through. The rain had stopped and the skies were blue. And oh, what a revelation to see. Someone was saying, I love you to me. A one in a million chance of a lifetime. And I show compassion and said to me, I'm cracking the notes. You sent to me a stroke of love called you. You and you and you. One in a million you. I was a lonely man with empty arms to fill. Till I found a piece of happiness to call my own. Life is worth living again. For to love you to me is to live. A one in a million chance of a lifetime. But life showed compassion and sent to me a stroke of love called you. A one in a million you. A one in a million. Of a lifetime, and I showed compassion and sent to me a stroke of love called you. A one in a million, you. My voice gave out, I'm sorry.